Well, isn't that a nice comment on my YouTube channel? By the way, subscribe. Ding, ding, hit the bell. Well done. Shared your vids with a couple of agents in my office. Thank you. Hopefully they will get some great tips from you, bud. Keep up the good work. Thank you for the comment, by the way. In today's video, we're gonna talk about who moved my cheese. I referenced this book in yesterday's vlog very quickly. I kind of skimmed over it, but it's actually a really good book and it is so relevant to so many aspects of our lives because it deals with change. I mean, let's face it, the job of a real estate agent has changed drastically. And so it would be very fitting for me to go over this book. It's not really a book review, so I don't want to call it a book review. I want to give you a very quick recap of the book and what that means for you as the real estate agent and what it means for the real estate industry. Here is a super quick version of it. So the story takes place in a maze and there are two mice. Their names are Sniff and Scurry. Brilliant. In that maze, there are also two little people the size of mice. Their names are Hem and Ha. Also good names. So every morning, Sniff and Scurry would wake up, they would put on their sneakers, and they would run through the maze to look for some cheese. They had simple brains. After all, they're just mice. They would hit a dead end. They would say, oh, it's a dead end. They would turn right or left and they would just try something else until eventually they got to the cheese. Also every morning, Hem and Ha would wake up and because they had human brains, which are very complex, they overthought everything. Maybe this way, I don't know, what do you think? They would analyze, but eventually, after some time, they too found the cheese. Now, after a while, Sniff and Scurry, the mice, and Hem and Ha, the little people, well, they kind of got used to where the cheese was. So every morning, they would go to their cheese, they would eat the cheese, and then they would go back home. Here's the difference between mice who have simple brains and the little people who have human brains. You see, Sniff and Scurry, they noticed that the big block of cheese every day was diminishing. They knew that one day the cheese wouldn't be there. They anticipated this change. Hem and Ha, they didn't realize that the pile of cheese was getting smaller. They thought the cheese was always going to be there. In fact, while Sniff and Scurry went back home every single day, and they always had their sneakers on them. They tied the sneakers around their neck because they knew that things could change at any moment. They would have to put the sneakers back on and they would have to go out find some different cheese maybe. Hem and Ha thought, well, this cheese is always going to be here. In fact, they took off their sneakers and they moved closer to the cheese. They invited their family and friends over to show off their cheese. Look how hard we worked to get this cheese. Damn it, we deserve this cheese. This is our cheese. They owned the cheese. But of course, they didn't realize the cheese one day may not be there and the cheese is getting old. So what do you think happened one day? Yup, the cheese was gone. What do you think Sniff and Scurry did? They anticipated that one day the cheese may not be there. They said, well, today is that day. They took the sneakers off their neck, they put them on their feet, and they went off to find more cheese. They went back into the maze. They didn't overthink it. They didn't make it any more complicated than it needed to be. They simply went out to find new cheese. Hem and Ha, well, that's a different story. When they woke up, they were in for a big surprise. They honestly thought that cheese was going to be there forever. This big, beautiful, shiny pile of cheese was always going to be there. They sat around, they pouted, they cried. Wah, no more cheese. They stomped around like five-year-olds. This isn't fair. Life isn't fair. Where is my cheese? They were too blind to notice that the cheese was disappearing. They thought good times were always going to be there every day. Every morning they woke up, the cheese is just going to be there. Do you think they put their sneakers back on to run back into the maze to look for new cheese like Sniff and Scurry? No, they sat around. They moped around. They were waiting for the cheese to return. They were hoping they were gonna wake up and the cheese somehow was going to come back. But it never did. And that's the difference between the simple brain of a mouse and the complex brain of us human beings. We overthink things. Now, of course, the cheese is just a metaphor for anything in life. But let's relate this back to real estate. Do you know of any agents who, in your mind, is, well, maybe they're not so smart. Actually, they seem kind of dumb. But for whatever reason, they always have business coming in. And you always think to yourself, how are they getting business? I am way smarter than they are. I know how to sell homes way better than they do. My marketing is way better than theirs. How do they end up with all the business? And maybe that's the problem. They don't overthink it. They just go where the cheese is. I've done that so many times in my real estate career. Overcomplicating things. Overthinking things. And you can't do that in the real estate industry because the real estate industry is always changing. Homes are not sold the same way today like they were 50 years ago. Prospecting's not the same today that then it was, let's say, even 10 years ago. The cheese keeps moving. And Hem and Ha in this book, they wondered, who moved my cheese? In other words, they wanted the good old days to come back, but the good old days are gone. It wasn't too long ago where the public relied on you to get access to the MLS. Well, that cheese has been moved. Buyers and sellers have the same access, practically the same access, as a real estate agent does. So now where's the new cheese? We all have two choices. Well, we have many choices, but referencing the book, we have two choices. We can move with the times, or we can wait around for the good times to come back. But I think deep down inside, we know the good times are not coming back. So the key is to create the new good times. Because the good times are still here. They've just been moved to another part of the maze. And it's up to you to go back into that maze to find the new pile of cheese. Sniff and Scurry knew the cheese was getting old and the pile was dwindling down. While Hem and Ha, they were clueless to that. And as the real estate industry changes, we have to look inside and say, okay, first of all, is it changing? The answer is yes, it's always changing. So the second question is, how do we get in front of that change? And when you understand how to get in front of that change, and not be afraid of the change and adjust with the times, business will go on as normal. There are a few things, every few pages I will come across something like this, and they're just really cool sayings that I want to read out to you. The more important your cheese is to you, the more you want to hold on to it. And as I already mentioned, the MLS is now accessible by the public. I remember when that change took place here and agents were freaking out. Are we going to become extinct? The answer is no, you're not going to become extinct. So what? So the public has access. But I started asking myself better questions. What can I do now that the public has access? What can I do differently to help the buyer and seller? With better questions come better answers. If you do not change, you can become extinct. It was only a few short years ago where social media didn't exist. Many agents saying, oh, it's just a fad, this Facebook thing, that's not gonna last. And that was a huge argument that my real estate coach and I had. I tried explaining to her, look what's happening. Things are changing. We have to change with the times. And my real estate coach acted like Hem and Ha. She wouldn't hear it. She says, no, that's the way real estate's always been done. That's the way it will always be done. By the way, if you, my ex-coach, are watching this video, pick up a copy of this book. It will do you some good. That's 10,000 bucks I'll never get back. Movement in a new direction helps you find cheese. And it freaked me out after I fired my coach because I tried something new. I had this gut feeling that it has to work. So I just moved in a different direction, in a new direction. I started creating content with my video camera. Did it work? Yeah. When you stop being afraid, you feel good. There's a lot of fear out there in this industry. Imagine yourself enjoying your new cheese leads you to it. If you don't have a target, what are you aiming for? And every time I try something new, whether it was in the real estate industry or now in this new coaching venture, I always envision the end result. What is that going to look like? Because now I know which direction to go into. The quicker you let go of old cheese, the sooner you find new cheese. And of course, it's scary to let go of something, but it's the letting go that allows you to go into a different direction. It's like Tarzan. You have to let go of the vine behind you in order for you to fully grasp the vine in front of you. You have to let go of the past in order to move forward. Old beliefs do not lead you to new cheese. My coach told me to call you. What do you mean you don't want to sell your home? When you see that you can find and enjoy new cheese, you change course. It was scary for me to go out there and try to generate leads making content. And I messed up big time in the beginning, but I kept changing course until eventually my first lead came in. And it was at that moment that I realized this is going to work. And as a result, it allowed me to change course. Noticing small changes early helps you adapt to bigger changes that are to come. I think I'm just gonna stop making comments now and just read these out to you. Move with the cheese and enjoy it. That was the last one. My final thoughts. Change is inevitable. It's happening every day, whether we want it to or not. Instead of running away or being afraid of change, embrace it and ask different questions. When you see changes coming around the corner, don't put the blinders on. Face it dead on and ask, what does this mean? What do I need to do to get in front of that change? If you embrace change, you will be unstoppable. I promise you. Let the other agents fear for their business, fear for their income, fear for their commission checks. The quicker you drop the fear, the quicker you will realize what you need to do. Embrace change. All right, I think we're done here. Before you move on your day, please click the like button if you like this video, subscribe and hit that bell. You wanna hit the bell. I know you wanna hit the bell. So go ahead, hit the bell. Good stuff, Bob. Good stuff, viewer. Take care.